show that the set G equals to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is an abelian group with respect to addition modulo 7. This set G consists of 7 elements from 0 to 6. First, we have to form the composition table. Write the elements of G in the first row as well as the first column. Here we write the operation. This addition modulo 7 is the binary operation. We are going to add the corresponding elements. This is called topmost row. Consider first row headed 0. We have to add 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 1 is 1, 0 plus 2 is 2, 0 plus, actually here when you say plus, it is the addition modulo 7. 0 plus 3 is 3, 0 plus 4 is 4, 0 plus 5 is 5, 0 plus 6 is 6. Let us consider the second row, that is a row headed by the number 1. So 1 plus 0 is 1, 1 plus 1 is 2, 1 plus 2 is 3, 1 plus 3 is 4, 1 plus 4 is 5, 1 plus 5 is 6, 1 plus 6 is not 7 because it is 1 addition modulo 7, 6. That is when 1 plus 6 is added, the sum is 7. When 7 is divided by 7, the remainder is 0. Therefore, we have to write 0 here. We should not write 7. If the number is exceeds or equal to 7, we have to write the remainder. Now consider third row, this row headed by the number 2. 2 plus 0 is 2, 2 plus 1 is 3, 2 plus 2 is 4, 2 plus 3 is 5, 2 plus 4 is 6, 2 plus 5. 2 plus 5 is 7. When 7 is divided by 7, the remainder is 0. Then 2 plus addition modulo 7, 6. That is, this number exceeds 7. Therefore, 2 plus 6 is 8. When 8 is divided by 7, the remainder is 1. Therefore, here it is 1. Now, consider the fourth row headed by the element 3. We have to add this. 3 plus 0 is 3, 3 plus 1 is 4, 3 plus 2 is 5, 3 plus 3 is 6, 3 plus 4 is 7. When 7 is divided by 7, the remainder is 0. Now consider the fifth row headed by the number 4. 4 plus 0 is 4, 4 plus 1 is 5, 4 plus 2 is 6, 4 plus 3 is 7. When 7 is divided by 7, the remainder is 0. So 4 plus 4 is 8. When 8 is divided by 7, the remainder is 1. 4 plus 5 is 9. When 9 is divided by 7, the remainder is 2. Then 4 plus 6 is 10. When 10 is divided by 7, the remainder is 3. Similarly, we can write the 5th row as well as 6th row. And hence, this is the composition table which this consists of. This is the topmost row is nothing but elements of G. And hence, the first row is also elements of G. The set G contains 7 elements. Namely, G equals to the set 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now we are going to form the composition table. Composition table, let us write the elements of G in the topmost row and in the first column. This is known as topmost row. Now we are going to fill the elements in the first row headed by 0. 0 plus 0 is 0. When you say plus, we mean addition modulo 7. Whenever the sum is 7, we write 0. If the sum exceeds 7, then we have to write the remainder. 0 plus 1 is 1, 0 plus 2 is 2, 0 plus 3 is 3, 0 plus 4 is 4, 0 plus 5 is 5, 0 plus 6 is 6. So these are the elements in the first row headed by 0. Now we are going to fill the second row headed by the element 1. 1 plus 0 is 1, 1 plus 1. Now once we completed the first row, simply we can fill the first column here. The reason is the question is showed that G, addition modulo 7 forms an abelian group. When you say abelian group, this must satisfy commutative law. How do you verify commutative law in the composition table? The elements in the row must be same as elements in the corresponding column. That is, in the first row, these are the elements. Then the first column, we must have the same element in the same order. Therefore, now without any calculation, simply we fill these elements 1 to 6. Finished. Now coming to second row, the row headed by number 1. 1 plus 1 is 2, 1 plus 2 is 3, 1 plus 3 is 4, 1 plus 4 is 5, 1 plus 5 is 6, 1 plus 6 is 7. When 7 is divided by 7, the remainder is 0. Having filled the second row, now we are going to fill the second column. What are you going to do? Simply write the elements in the same order. That is, 2 is there already, 3, 4, 5, 6, 0, we write here. Now we are going to fill the third row headed by the number 2. 2 plus 2 is 4, 2 plus 3 is 5, 2 plus 4 is 6, 2 plus 5 is 7. When the sum 7 is divided by 7, the remainder is 0. 2 plus 6 is 8. When 8 is divided by 7, the remainder is 1. Having filled the third row, we are going to fill the third column. Already 3 elements are over. Now we are going to fill another 4 elements in the same order. That is 5, 6, 0, 1. Now we are going to fill the fourth row and the row headed by number 3. 3 plus 3 is 6. 6. 3 plus 4 is 7. When 7 is divided by 7, the remainder is 0. 3 plus 5 is 8. When 8 is divided by 7, the remainder is 1. 3 plus 6 is 9. When 9 is divided by 7, the remainder is 2. Having filled the fourth row, we are going to fill the fourth column. Only 3 elements are left over. Those 3 elements are 0, 1 and 2. Now, we are going to fill the fifth row headed by the number 4. 4 plus 4 is 8. When 8 is divided by 7, 1 is the remainder. 4 plus 5 is 9. When 9 is divided by 8, the remainder is 2. 4 plus 6 is 10. When 10 is divided by 7, the remainder is 3. Now we have to fill the fifth column. 2 elements are left over. What are they? 2 and 3. Now we are going to fill the sixth row headed by number 5. 5 plus 5 is 10. When 10 is divided by 7, 3 is the remainder. 5 plus 6 is 11. When 11 is divided by 7, the remainder is 4. Now we are going to fill the sixth column. So 4, therefore you have to write here 4. Now the last number, 6 plus 6 is 12. When 12 is divided by 7, the remainder is 5. This is how we fill any table without any difficulty. Now using this table, we can prove all the axioms instantaneously. Closure law. All the entries in the composition tables are the elements of G. Since G has 7 elements from 0 to 6, this table consists of 49 elements. This is a table square matrix. This consists of 49 elements. All these 49 elements are nothing but 0 to 6. Therefore, all the 49 entries in the composition table are the elements of G. Therefore, G is closed with respect to addition modulo 7. The next one is associativity. The elements of G are integers. They are from 0 to 6. They are all integers, non-negative integers. and the addition modulo m of integers are associative. That you have already proved in one of the theorems. Therefore, g is associative with respect to addition modulo 7. The next one is the existence of identity. It is very clear that 0 addition modulo 0 is 0, 0 addition modulo 7 is 1, 0 addition modulo 7 is 2, 0 plus 3 is 3, 0 plus 4 is 4, 0 plus 5 is 5, 0 plus 6 is 6. That is, 0 addition modulo 7 into a equal to a for all a in g. Here the small a takes a value from 0 to 6. Therefore, 0 is the identity element of G with respect to addition modulo 7. Or, we see that the row headed by the very first element 0 is exactly same as the topmost row. Look at the corresponding elements of the first row and the topmost row. Same. 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, 6. And hence, the element headed by the 0, and hence this 0 is the identity element. This is how we can find the identity from the composition table. The next one is the inverse. Since 0 is the identity element, 0 addition modulo 7, 0 equal to 0. Therefore, 0 is the inverse of 7. 1 addition modulo 7, 6 is equals to 1 plus 6 is 7. When 7 is divided by 7, the remainder is 0. That is, 0 is the identity element. Therefore, we say 1 is the inverse of 6, or 6 is the inverse of 1. This can be, we can found from the table itself. Consider this. We know that 0 is the identity. Look at the first row headed by 0. Where is 0? The very first element. Because this is the identity, and hence the corresponding element in the topmost row, namely 0. Therefore, inverse of 0 is 0. Now we are going to find the inverse of 1. How do you find inverse of 1? Consider the row headed by 1. Elements are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 0. Where is the identity? We know 0 is the identity. Where it is? It is the last element. Therefore, the corresponding element in the topmost row, that is 6, and hence the inverse of 1 is 6. Similarly, we are going to find the inverse of 2. What's inverse of 2? Inverse of 2 is, where is the identity? Yeah, it is here. What's the corresponding element in the topmost row? 5. And hence, the inverse of 2 is 5, or the inverse of 5 is 2. Similarly, we are going to find the inverse of 3. Consider the row headed by the element 3. In this row, where is the identity element? It is here. Because 0 is the identity element, whose corresponding element is 4 in the topmost row. Therefore, the inverse of 3 is 4. Now, inverse of 5. Where is the identity? 0. What's the corresponding element in the topmost row? 3. And hence the inverse of 4 is 3. Inverse of 4 is 3. Now inverse of 5. 0 is the identity. And hence the corresponding element in the topmost row is 2. Therefore the inverse of 5 is 2. Inverse of 5 is 2. Now 6. The inverse of 6. Where is the identity? Here is the identity. Corresponding element in the topmost row is 1, and hence the inverse of 6 is 1. This is how we find the inverse, or you can do this way. This is a tedious method, it takes time. So from the table itself we can find the inverse. So the element is 0 whose inverse is 0, inverse of 1 is 6, inverse of 6 is 1, inverse of 2 is 5, inverse of 5 is 2, inverse of 3 is 4, inverse of 4 is 3. We shall now prove the commutativity law. Every row is same as the corresponding column in the composition table. Let us verify this. This is a composition table. This is the topmost row, first column, leaving it. We have to consider the rest of the elements. This is the first row. First row contains element 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. first column 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. See, the corresponding units are same. 2, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, 6. Consider second row. Second row containing the elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 0. Second column contains elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 0. The same elements, corresponding elements are same. Second row as well as second column. Third row. Third row, we have elements 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 0, 1. Start with 2. Consider third column here. It also starts with 2. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 0, 1. Similarly, the fourth row. 3, 4, 5, 6, 0, 1, 2. Fourth column, exactly. 3, 4, 5, 6, 0, 1, 2. Similarly, the rest of corresponding rows and columns are exactly same. Therefore, we say that every row is same as the corresponding column in the composition table. Therefore, G satisfies commutative law with respect to addition modulo 7. Thus, G satisfies all the 5 axioms, namely closure axiom, associative axioms, identity axioms, inverse axiom, and the commutative law. Thus, the algebraic structure G together with addition modulo 7 is an abelian group. Show that the set of integers G equals to 1, 5, 7, 11 forms an abelian group with respect to multiplication modulo 12. G consists of only 4 elements, 1, 5, 7, 11. What are the elements? They are all relatively prime to 12. That is, the greatest common divisor of 1 and 12 is 1. The greatest common divisor of 5 and 12 is 1. The greatest common divisor of 7 and 12 is 1. The highest common factor of 11 and 12 is 1. Therefore, whenever the highest common factor of any two elements is 1, we say they are relatively prime. And hence, these elements are relatively prime to 12. Now, G consists of 1, 5, 7, 11. We will now show how to fill this composition table. G contains 4 elements, 1, 5, 7, 11. Now, let us fill the composition table. Write the elements of G in the topmost row and in the first column. Now, this row is called top row or topmost row. Now, we are going to fill the elements in the first row headed by number 1. 1 into 1 is 1, 1 into 5 is 5, 1 into 7 is 7, 1 into 11 is 11. When I say into multiplication, it means multiplication modulo 12. Now, let us, having filled the first row, it is very easy to fill the first column. And the reason is, we have to show that the given algebraic structure G, multiplication modulo 12 forms an abelian group. When you say abelian group, it must obey the commutative law. When you say commutative law, the elements in a row is equals to elements in the corresponding column. And hence, the elements in the first row must be same as elements in the first column. Therefore, the three elements, the three blanks can be filled by 5, 7, 11. Now we are going to fill the second row, that is the row headed by number 5. 5 into 5, 25. When 25 is divided by 12, 1 is the remainder. 5, multiplication modulo 12 into 7. That is 5 sevens are 35. When 35 is divided by 12, the remainder is 11. 5 into 11, 55. When 55 is divided by 12, the remainder is 7. Having filled the second row, we are going to fill the second column. Only two blanks are here. two cells are to be filled. Those two cells are nothing but 11 and this 7 without any calculation. Now we are going to fill the third row. In third row already two elements are filled. Now we are going to fill two more cells. 7 into 7, 7 sevens are 49. When 49 is divided by 12, 1 is the remainder. What's the number left over here? 7 has come, 11 has come, 1 has come, next number is 5. That's it. Because 7 into 11 is 77. When 77 is divided by 12, the remainder is 5. Now, here this is 5, therefore it must be 5 here. In this last row, we have 5, 7, 11. What is missing number? 1. So write 1 here. Because 11 elevens are 121. When 121 is divided by 12, 1 is the remainder. Now we have to show that the algebraic structure G, multiplication modulo 12 is an abelian group. The first one is closure axiom. All the entries in the composition table are elements of G. Yes, there are G consists of 4 elements, therefore there are 16 elements in the table, and all these elements 1, 5, 7, 11, 5, 1, 11, 7, 7, 11, 1, 5, 11, 7, 5, 1, they are all the 16 elements are elements of G. And hence, G is closed with respect to multiplication modulo 12. The elements of G are integers. Yes, 1, 5, 7, 11 are integers. And the multiplication modulo M of integers are associative. Therefore, G satisfies associative law with respect to matrix, with respect to multiplication modulo 12. Therefore, G satisfies associative law with respect to multiplication modulo 12. Next one is identity. How to find identity from the composition table? We know that the elements headed by... How to find identity element from the composition table? We know that any row headed by some element is exactly same as the topmost row, then that particular element is called identity element. If you consider the topmost row, it is 1, 5, 7, 11. Now, we have to see the 4 rows are there, row 1, 2, 3, 4. Which row is exactly same as 1, 5, 7, 11? It is nothing but the very first row headed by the number 1, and hence the number 1 is the identity element. Now we have to find the inverse. How to find the inverse of an element? Now if you want to find the inverse of 1, consider the row headed by 1. Here the elements are 1, 5, 7, 11. What is the identity element? 1 is the identity element. Where is 1 in this row? Here is 1. What's the corresponding element in the topmost row? It is 1. Therefore, the inverse of 1 is 1. Inverse of 1 is 1. How do you find the inverse of 5? To find the inverse of 5, consider the row headed by the number 5. The elements in the row are 5, 1, 11, 7. We know that 1 is the identity element. Therefore, the corresponding element in the topmost row, namely 5, is the inverse of 5. And hence, inverse of 5 is 5. Next, we have to find the inverse of 7. Consider the row headed by the number 7. Elements are 7, 11, 1 and 5. But 1 is the identity element. Therefore, the corresponding element in the topmost row is 7. Therefore, the inverse of 7 is 7. Inverse of 7 is 7. Next, we have to find the inverse of 11. For that, consider the row headed by 11. This is the row headed by the number 11. Here, where is the identity element? The last one. It is the identity element. Therefore, the corresponding element, namely 11, is the inverse of 11. And hence, the inverse of 1 is 1, inverse of 5 is 5, inverse of 7 is 7, inverse of 11 is 11. That is, every element has its own inverse, that is self-inverse. Thus, each element of G possesses inverse in it. Therefore, the algebraic structure G, multiplication model 12 is a group. The last one is the commutative law. Every row is same as the corresponding column in the composition table. Yes, the first row, 1, 5, 7, 11. First column, 1, 5, 7, 11. Second row, 5, 1, 11, 7. Second column, 5, 1, 11, 7. Third row, 7, 11, 1, 5. Third column, 7, 11, 1, 5. Fourth row, 11, 7, 5, 1. Fourth column, 11, 7, 5, 1. That is, every row is same as the corresponding column. This implies multiplication modulo 12 is commutative in G. Therefore, G satisfies commutative law with respect to multiplication modulo 12. Thus, G satisfies all the five axioms, namely closure, associative, identity, inverse, and commutative. Therefore, the algebraic structure G, multiplication model 12 is an abelian group. Show that the set of integers capital G equals to 1, 3, 5, 7 forms an abelian group with respect to multiplication modulo 8. The set G contains 4 elements, namely 1, 3, 5, 7. What are these 4 elements 1, 3, 5, 7? Clearly, they are all relatively prime to 8. We say the 2 elements are relatively prime if their greatest common divisor is 1. Here, the greatest common divisor of 1 and 8 is 1. The greatest common divisor of 3 and 8 is 1. The GCD of 5 and 8 is 1. The greatest common divisor of 7 and 8 is 1. And hence, G consists of the elements which are all relatively prime to 8. Now we are going to show that this G, together with the binary operation, namely multiplication modulo 8, forms an abelian group. Consider the set G containing 4 elements. 1, 3, 5, 7. Since G contains 4 elements and the composition table will be having 4 into 4, 16 elements. These are the 16 elements. We know how to form the table. Now let us form the composition table. The topmost row containing the elements of G in the order. Similarly, the first column, this column also contains elements of G in the same order. Now we have to take the product. Here the composition is multiplication modulo 8. So when I say multiplication, it means multiplication modulo 8. So 1 into 1 is 1. 1 3s are 3. 1 5s are 5. 1 7s are 7. First row. For the second row, the second row headed by number 3. Now we are going to multiply each and every element of G by 3. So 3 1s are 3, 3 3s are 9. Whenever the number exceeds this number 8, we have to divide the number and write the remainder. When 9 is 3 into 3 is 9, 9 is divided by 7, 1 is the remainder. Similarly, 3 5s are 15. Whenever 15 is divided by 8, the remainder is 7. Next, 3 7s are 21. When 21 is divided by 8, the remainder is 5, because 8 2s are 16. 21 minus 16 is 5. Now consider the third row headed by the element 5. We are going to multiply this with every element of G. 3, 5 ones are 5. 5 threes are 15. When 15 is divided by 8, remainder is 7. 5 fives are 25. When 25 is divided by 8, the remainder is 1. 5 sevens are 35. When 35 is divided by 8, the remainder is 3. Similarly, the last row headed by 7. 7 ones are 7. 7 threes are 21. When 21 is divided by 8, 4, 5 is the remainder. 7 fives are 35. When 35 is divided by 8, the remainder is 3. 7 sevens are 49. When 49 is divided by 8, the remainder is 1. Now this composition table consists of 16 elements because G has 4 elements, and hence the composition table will have 16 elements. These are the 16 elements. Now, closure law. All the entries, all the 16 entries in the composition table are the elements of G. Therefore, G is closed with respect to multiplication modulo 8. The second one is associativity. The elements of G are integers. The integers are 1, 3, 5, 7. And the multiplication modulo M of integers are associative. Therefore, G satisfies associative with respect to multiplication modulo 7. Clearly, 1 into 1 is 1, 1, 3 is 3, 1 into 5 is 5, 1 into 7 is 7. And hence, 1 is the identity element with respect to multiplication modulo 8. Then how do you find the identity from the composition table? Look at the 4 rows headed by 1, 3, 5, 7. Which row is exactly same as the topmost row? It is clearly the first row, namely the row headed by the number 1, 1, 1, 3, 3, 5, 5, 7, 7. And hence, the row headed by the number 1 is exactly same as the elements in the topmost row. Therefore, this element 1 is the identity element. Now, let us find the inverse. How do you find the inverse from the composition table? Consider the first row headed by 1. We are going to find the inverse of 1. And we know that inverse of identity is itself. Inverse of identity is itself. Therefore, inverse of 1 is 1. How do you find it? Look at the row headed by 1. Here, elements are 1, 3, 5, 7. Which is the identity element? 1 is the identity element. And hence, the corresponding element in the topmost row is 1. Therefore, the inverse of 1 is 1. Now, to find the inverse of 3, look at the row headed by the number 3. The elements are 3, 1, 7, 5. Which is the identity element in this row? 1 is the identity element. What is the corresponding element in the topmost row? It is 3. Therefore, the inverse of 3 is 3. The inverse of 3 is 3. Now let us find the inverse of 5. For that, consider the row headed by number 5. Elements are 5, 7, 1, 3. Among these 4 elements, where is the identity? Here is the identity. What's the corresponding element in the topmost row? 5 is the number, and hence the inverse of 5 is 5. The inverse of 5 is 5. Now, the last element, consider the fourth row headed by number 7. The elements are 7, 5, 3, 1. Where is the identity? The last element is 1. Therefore, the corresponding element in the topmost row is 7. Thus, the inverse of 7 is 7. Thus, inverse of 1 is 1, inverse of 3 is 3, inverse of 5 is 5, inverse of 7 is 7. That is, every element has its own inverse, that is self-inverse. Thus, each element of G possesses inverse innate. Thus, G, addition modulo 8 is a group. Now, commutative law. What's commutative law? Look at the first row, 1, 3, 5, 7. First column, 1, 3, 5, 7. Look at the second row, 3, 1, 7, 5. Second column, 3, 1, 7, 5. Third row, 5, 7, 1, 3. Third column, 5, 7, 1, 3. Fourth row, 7, 5, 3, 1. Fourth column, 7, 5, 3, 1. That is, every row is same as the corresponding column in the composition table. This implies that multiplication modulo 8 is commutative in G. Therefore, G satisfies commutative law with respect to multiplication modulo 8. Therefore, the algebraic structure G, multiplication modulo 8 is an abelian group.